This is the beginning. This is the day. You are watching the unfolding of one of history's great adventures. Man's colonization of space beyond the stars. This is Alpha Control, 0 -1 hour and 15 minutes and holding. Delay caused by difficulty with liquid oxygen loading valve. 0 -1 hour and 15 minutes and holding. TV satellite control, take over.
Ladies and gentlemen, today the first of what may be as many as 10 million families per year is setting out on its epic voyage into man's newest frontier for colonization, deep space.
Reaching out into other worlds from our desperately overcrowded planet, a series of deep thrust telescopic probes have conclusively established a planet orbiting the star Alpha Centauri as the only one within range of our technology able to furnish ideal conditions for human existence. Even now, the family chosen for this incredible journey into space is preparing to take their final pre-liftoff physical tests. The Robinson family was selected from more than 2 million volunteers for its unique balance of scientific achievement, emotional stability, and pioneer resourcefulness. They will spend the 5.5 years of their voyage frozen into a state of suspended animation, which will terminate automatically as the spacecraft enters the atmosphere of the new planet.
This is Alpha Control. We are at 0 -1 hour and 15 minutes and still holding. We have also encountered an electrical power failure in our computer at the lunar tracking station. Zero -1 hour and 15 minutes and still holding.
Here now is the Jupiter 2, the culmination of nearly 40 years of intensive research and the most sophisticated piece of hardware yet devised by the mind of man. Bold in concept, brilliant in execution, this most delicate yet most colossal of instruments makes possible man's thrust into deep space and will soon set out on its quest for a new world. This super spaceship stands 2 stories high. The upper level contains a fantastic, sophisticated guidance control system. An electronic elevator connects both floors of the intergalactic vehicle. The upper and lower levels are operationally self-contained. Here, on the lower deck, pulsating with unbelievable force, are the great atomic motors that will power the ship to new worlds. Spectacular but functional living quarters, including staterooms and galley, complete this level. There is one additional member of this expedition, an environmental control robot, key among whose many vital functions will be the final analysis of the physical environment of the new planet. This historic flight, preceded by nearly a decade of intensive research and preparation, has been shrouded by the most rigorous security precautions. Other nations, in even more desperate need for breathing room on our critically crowded planet, are racing the United States in this project. Countries that would go to any lengths of sabotage. Control. 0-1 hour and 15 minutes. And still holding.
Turn that thing off, soldier!
Sorry, Colonel. There is no personnel allowed in here after 0-6 hours.
Do you know who I am, soldier?
Sir, I wouldn't care if you were President of the USA. I'd still have to put you under arrest.
Of course, that's your duty. But just for the record, I came in here to check the helium-nitrogen ratio. I had a sudden feeling I turned a valve the wrong way. You know how it is when you get those feelings that won't let you sleep. I had to come back and make sure.
Sorry, sir, but I still have to turn you over to the officer of the day.
Naturally. Don't apologize. You've got your job and I've got mine, eh, soldier?
Thank you.
Aeolus 14 Umbra. Aeolus 14 Umbra. Reporting, mission accomplished. I have reprogrammed the robot. His power has been activated. Exactly 8 hours after launch, the robot will destroy the spaceship with all hands aboard. Repeat. 8 hours after launch, the robot will destroy the spaceship.
This is Alpha Control. All technical difficulties have been resolved and we are resuming countdown. The count now stands at 0 minus 1 hour and 14 minutes. All systems are now green and go.
In these last minutes before liftoff, we're hoping to bring you a few words from the members of the Brave family making this historic journey. But I'm informed by Alpha Control that Dr. John Robinson, his wife Maureen, and their 3 children, Judy, Penny, and Will, are still undergoing their pre-liftoff final physical checks.
Physical condition. You're all in top shape and ready to go. I envy you your adventure.
Thank you, Doctor.
This is Alpha Control. The Robinson family will prepare to board the space vehicle at once. It is now 0 minus 33 minutes and counting.
Clever, shouldn't I? I just can't.
This is Alpha Control. The Robinson family will now board the spacecraft.
We're ready.
Mm-hmm.
this time.
Sure, he's our pilot.
Only a manner of speaking. Just in case something would happen to go wrong with the automatic guidance system, which isn't very likely.
If you wake up and find me driving, you'll know you're in trouble.
Minutes and counting. Technicians complete final checkouts.
Major? Dr. Robbins?
Goodbye, General.
Snug and secure, I trust.
And now, one moment, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
Fellow Americans. Friends all over the world. Upon the success of this mission,
I'll get a picture.
Will depend whether the explosive increase of population on this planet will ultimately lead to a disaster from which none will be exempt, or to a new dawn of plenty for all of humanity. None can predict the outcome of this audacious venture to the very stars. To those who have staked their lives upon this bold expansion of man's horizons, I humbly say, go in peace. The prayers of mankind are with you.
Inspiring, truly inspiring.
Completing disconnect check of non-flight systems. All circuits off. Power pack is removed.
This is Alpha Control. 0-2 minutes and counting.
Better hurry, Doc.
Yes, yes, coming right along.
Penny Robinson, enter tubes. Dr. Maureen Robinson, enter tubes. Miss Judy Robinson, enter tubes.
Thank you.
80 seconds. Range clearance to launch. Major Donald West, enter tube. Zero minus 65 seconds. Zero minus 55 seconds and counting. Dr. John Robinson, enter tube. Zero minus 45 seconds. Activate freezing units.
Electromagnetic miracles now come into play. This cosmic glow, induced through the genius of advanced technology, will put the Robinson family and Major West in limbo, enabling them to make an endless flight while aging but a second in the time of man. From this moment on, our space travelers will be in a state of suspended animation, which will last for the next 5.5 years. Zero minus 30.
Escape velocity. Remote readings here at Alpha Control appear normal with no indication of change.
medical telemeter show all members of the Robinson family are safe and well. Still in their total blackout of suspended animation.
This 40 number. Come in, please. Do you read me? Mission accomplished. Mission accomplished. What do I do now? What clever instructions do you have for me now? And how much more money are you going to pay me? This excursion. Aeolus 14 Umbra. Do you know where I am? Do you know?
Return us to Earth? Repeat! Can you return us to Earth? Alpha Control, this is Jupiter 2!
Alpha Control, this is Lunar Tracking Station 2 Omega.
Go ahead, Lunar Tracking.
We've got a problem with the Jupiter 2 flight profile. It is now negative. Repeat, negative.
Hello, Lunar Tracking. Hello, Alpha Control. Does anybody read me?
Roger, we've been working on it. Our computers tell us there's close to 200 pounds excess weight aboard. It has altered the flight pattern.
Abort the mission. Can you hear me? Abort the mission!
Alpha Control, initiate an immediate course change. Jupiter 2 is headed directly for a massive meteor swarm.
Negative. Vector controls aren't effective.
Major West. Major West! Can you hear me?
Major West. I am Major West.
Controls! Fast!
are you doing aboard?
I was trapped just before liftoff. Your helium nitrogen ratio. I neglected to adjust the balance control valve. The hatch closed before I could. It's horrible.
With your extra weight, Lord, no wonder the automatic navigator didn't pull us out of it in time.
Put us about. Get us back home.
Can you? What have you done to the transmitter?
I don't know. I must have lost my head. I was trying to reach out for control. For Earth. Every second you waste sends us thousands of miles in the wrong direction. What are you doing?
Waking up the Robinsons.
No. Don't wake them.
Why not? It's their lives too, and since I'm the only one who can pilot this ship, I'll make the decisions.
Have it your way then. Make it a family outing. Why not? Precisely the point I'm trying to make. Without much success, I might add.
Where's Alpha Centauri?
It's out there. Somewhere.
Gee, it looks like we're standing still.
Well, of course, we don't know how far yet. Don's trying to determine whether we should return to Earth or not.
There's no question about what we must do. You saw your wife's metabolic reaction to the suspended animation state? I warn you, Robinson,
He might not survive another such trauma.
Oh, don't worry, darling. No matter what we decide, I won't let you back in that tube.
The media's clobbered us. Our whole control system's badly damaged.
You're supposed to be a space pilot and qualified. Improvise something. Turn us around and get us back to Earth.
If I were you, Colonel, I'd keep my mouth shut.
Dan!
You're responsible for this mess we're in.
Really, Major? Have you bothered to wonder who revived you? You tumbled out of there like a block of ice, dead as a coffin nail. Who do you think brought you back to life?
Thanks. Our payload was calculated to a fraction of an ounce. Without his extra weight, we would have ducked the media storm automatically.
Maybe and maybe not. But without me, not one of you would be alive now.
All right, Colonel Smith. We're properly grateful. Right now, we have to make a decision. I'm not sure we should turn back, even if we can.
Look here. You people volunteered for this expedition. I did not. I have no business being here. I demand to be taken back to Earth.
Don, do you have any idea of our present position?
Not precisely. Maybe we can calculate it. Luckily, the atomic clock is still working. It's nearly 8 hours since takeoff. Now, these vector tapes, they could be of help. I was afraid of that.
What is it?
The tapes are damaged.
Well, is there any way we can repair the inertial navigation system?
I can try, but it means shutting off the artificial gravity for a while.
All right, do it. Will, Penny! Now listen, we're not going to have any gravity for a while, so we're all going to have to hang on.
Out now.
Do a flip.
Gee, that looks like fun.
Would you like to try it? Having fun up there?
Look out, you're going to bump into each other. Oh, my. Oh! Oh, look at me, Will.
Oh, my. Come on now.
Oh, no,
come
I don't want to go down yet. Wait a minute.
Now, that's
enough. Come on, Will. Let me back down here.
Program him to play chess. You play chess, don't you? Ever play on a three-dimensional board? Did you know that I was the Grand Master of the Oxford University Chess Society for 3 years running? Oh, that. You have to disconnect it when you want to teach him something, or he's apt to go right off and do it. Chess board or no chess board.
My dad said you were left the board when it came down to adjust the helium nitrogen intake.
That's right.
But the helium nitrogen intake valve's on the upper level.
Oh? Well, who said anything about the intake valve? It's the emergency supply I was concerned about.
Then I'd better go back and tell them they were wrong about you.
Wrong? Well, what did they say?
Well, Major West said that when he went to cadet school, an excuse like yours wouldn't have got him out of Sunday chapel.
He said that, did he? Well, that's the military mind for you. Kill or be killed. That's all they understand.
Oh, but he's not like that.
Wait a minute. Say that again.
I said he's not like that.
That's what I was afraid of. Open your mouth a minute. How long have you had that?
Had what?
That touch of virus on your tongue. Feel it, can't you?
I guess so.
I must have been blind not to spot it before liftoff.
I thought freezing kills any virus.
You thought? It's a good thing I'm the doctor, not you. Do you know what that virus would have done while the rest of your body was in a state of metabolic deanimation? Just taken it over bit by bit. After 5 years, there'll be nothing left but the metal in your spacesuit. All the rest of you would be one big, raging mass of virus. I'd better go. go and tell your mom and dad. We've got to return to Earth immediately.
But...
stay right there. In quarantine.
Just because they're not isn't reason enough for me to abort a $30 billion mission.
Major, that $30 billion is just as much my money as it is yours. And I don't like to waste it either. But I'd gladly waste 100 times that much to safeguard my family. Now I say we turn back. Don't you have an opinion?
No, I don't. Not until we've checked every component inside out and know exactly how we stand.
And then?
And then I'll let the computer make the final decision.
And will the computer also take into consideration a man's love and concern for his family? Or has all that been put into cold storage for the duration?
Maureen, we knew perfectly well what we were getting into.
Dr. Smith, is it possible that certain parts of the body don't reanimate as quickly as others? The heart, for instance?
Mrs. Robinson, I'm afraid the decision no longer rests in your hands. Or the computer's.
What do you mean?
Your son.
What about him?
Oh, there's no cause for alarm, not yet at any rate.
Stop it! Stop it! I order you to stop!
Thank you.
We're going into a hyperdrive. We're out of control. It's incredible. Not one constellation you can recognize. Where are we?
Will. Where's Will?
Nothing. Nothing that matters now. Nothing.
Hello, Alpha Control. This is Lunar Tracking Station Copernicus. Jupiter 2 moving at incredible speed, far off course beyond range of our tracking instruments.
Lighthouse, this is Alpha Control. Message for President on Scrambler. Mr. President, status control on Jupiter 2. As of this moment, the spacecraft has passed the limits of our galaxy. It's presumed to be hopelessly lost in space.
I'm sure it's the NGS scanner. If you can fix it, we might be able to tell who we are.
I'll do my best.
Look, for the last time, spacewalking is part of my business. Let me do it.
Now, we've been through that. You're the only one that can pilot the ship. I'm expendable and you're not.
Hey,
see the scanner?
Yes, it's damaged all right.
Can you fix it?
I must have picked it up by reflex. Well, I'm only trying to make myself useful.
Tell John I'm coming out to shoot him this spare line.
John's going to shoot up now. He's going to shoot to the spare line with a rocket gun.
No, not Don. He's got to stay with the ship.
There is something useful you can do, Doctor. Suda.
First place, I am not an official member of this expedition. And in the second, I'm simply not in condition for it. The heart, at my age, it could go at once for this ancient body.
John, we're losing it!
Thank you. Thank you.